Praise the Lord. You see, you can't sit down and you can't sit down and let me do that again. Is there anybody in the house that loves Jesus Christ, the Son of God? Praise the Lord. Can you say praise the Lord? And do you love him? Is he the most awesome thing that ever happened in your life? Praise God. Hallelujah. We give him praise and glory. Somebody just give him a shout. Just praise him for what he's done in your life. Not for what he's going to do, but what he's already done. For he is glorious. And his power and his mercy and his grace and his forgiveness and his love endures forever and ever. Amen. You know, when you have a football game on and somebody gets a touchdown, or a baseball game, there's a home run, and we get all excited about that, or any other kind of sports game. And I was just talking to Pastor Gus, and I said, gosh, wouldn't it be awesome if how we get so excited about that event, that moment, if the church of Jesus Christ got that excited about him. So Jesus just made a touchdown in your life. And he's going to make a field goal tonight. What do you think about that? Is that exciting? More exciting than any game? More exciting than anything that ever happened in your life? Because tonight is the night of new beginnings. No matter where you're at in life, no matter what level of faith you have, or maybe there's somebody in here that doesn't know the Lord, but I'm telling you, you're going to find him tonight. You're going to find the Lord. You're going to find his peace. In his rest, and whatever else the rest of us are going through, we're going to get our faith strengthened. The word of God's going to come forth. The anointing of the Holy Spirit is going to fill this place. Right now, he's even at work on your heart, on your mind, on your situation. Amen? He's ready. Are you ready? Are you ready for what he has for you tonight? Hallelujah. Oh, just praise him. Just shout right now. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, give him praise. Put your hands together. Oh, can you say it? About the power of God. Keep going. Come on. The power of God will break every chain. The power of God will break every infirmity, every disease, every conflict, every addiction, affliction, conviction. The power of God. And there's power in the blood, and there's power in the very name of Jesus. So when you say his name, all the angels shout. All of heaven rejoices at the name of Jesus. Amen? So when you say the power of Jesus, when you say Jesus, he's listening. Hallelujah. The word says whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. And Jesus said, whoever prays in my name and believes it shall be done by my Father in heaven. And Jesus said, where two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. He's here. You see, there is power in the name of Jesus. There is power, power in his name. Mean it with your heart. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is
praise you for what you're gonna do. We praise you for everything you've done. We give you glory and honor tonight. We give you glory and honor tonight. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on. That's right. Jesus. There's power in the very name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We are gathered together here in the name of Jesus, surrendering ourselves, surrendering our burdens, our trials, no matter what's going on in our lives, our convictions, our addictions, our little problems, our crazy thoughts, where the devil tries to get in our minds and tries to twist things around and around and around and around and won't let us go forward. The devil wants us to keep us in the past. But today, tonight, we lay it at the foot of the cross. All those things, everything going on in your life, you need to let it go and let God. And we're going to put it at the foot of his cross right here. Amen. We're going to give it to him, and then we're going to move forward tonight. Amen. Jesus, at the cross you beckon me, draw me gently to my knees, and I will lost for words. I'm in love, I'm sweetly broken, only surrender. At the cross you beckon me, come on, draw me gently to my knees, and I'm lost for words. Oh, so in love. We laid at the cross of Jesus. And he said that for all those who believe in him, amen. And he said, whatever we ask for, whatever we pray, in his name, believing that it will be done by our Father in heaven according to his will. Not everything we pray for is in his will. So tonight we ask, Lord, let your will be done in our lives. No more, no less. Your will, Father, in Jesus' name, your will, Father. Come on, let me hear you say it to him. Your will, Lord.
At the cross you beckon me, draw me gently to my knees, and I am lost for words. I'm so in love, I'm sweetly broken, holy.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for what you're going to do tonight. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here. We welcome you into our hearts, into our minds, into our very being to do your will, to restore, refresh, renew. And we thank you, Father, for the increase of the power and the presence of your Spirit here. And we thank you, Father, in advance as we lay it all at your feet. All of our problems do not matter anymore tonight, because we're here to receive from you in the mighty name of Jesus. And everybody said, amen. With the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. With the Spirit of the Lord is, with the Spirit of the Lord. Oh!
where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Do it again. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Now at the top of your lungs, say, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. Now give him a shout and claim that from heaven. Claim your freedom. Claim your freedom. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, we give you praise, Lord. We give you praise, Lord. Jesus. Jesus, you're glorious. Hallelujah. We give you praise. You got some other music going on, brother. Somebody's jamming over back there. Praise God. Praise God. It's all good. Amen. It kind of went with the song, right? Hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Come on, give him another shout. Because we're not going to let any distraction fill this place. We're not going to let any distraction enter our minds. We're going to focus on the worshiping of our Lord and Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. You know, John wrote down Jesus' words about worship. And Jesus said, but there's a time coming, and it's already here, when true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. He said the Father is looking for anyone who will worship him in this way. For God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship him in spirit. Now, the word says, as we just sang, that the Lord is now spirit. And where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's freedom. Do you understand that? Right here, right now, you can receive it or you can reject it. Amen. And the prophet wrote down what God said like this in 2 Chronicles, when if my people who are called by my name. Are you called by his name? Are you children of God? Say, I'm a child of God. When you're a child of God, there's no more fear. For fear is the opposite of faith. Amen? So we give him praise, and we declare that we are no longer that way. I'm no longer a slave to fear, because I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. Amen. I am a child of God. Hallelujah.
I'm no longer.
Satan right now, I am a child of God. Tell him again, I am a child of God. Tell him again, I am a child of God. Do it again now. I am a child. Hallelujah. Give him praise and glory. Give him praise and glory. Hallelujah. Glory.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise Jesus.
He's worthy of praise. Glory. He's worthy of all the honor and all the glory. Jesus, we just exalt you tonight in this place. You said if we would lift you up, you would draw all men unto you. So we lift up your name in this place, and we thank you for the power that is in your name, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad you came to church tonight? Yeah. Praise God. Well, just greet the person next to you, and then you can be seated. Just have a few announcements tonight. And if you're here for the first time, would you raise your hand? We want to welcome you. If you're here tonight, praise God. We're glad that you came to worship with us tonight, and if you could stop by the bookstore on your way out and fill out an information card, we'd love to hear how you heard about the church, and I believe we have a gift for you as well, so please do that. We have Bible studies every Wednesday night at 6:30. The men meet over in the youth building. The women are meeting in the kitchen. We do have childcare available, so please make yourselves available to that. It's just an awesome way to get to know the other men and women in the church, but also to enhance your life spiritually and be discipled. And we all need that, don't we? We all need to grow. We have prayer every Monday night at 7 p.m. How many of you have been coming to prayer? Praise God. Well, we need the rest of you there as well. Amen? We're binding together to pray for this ministry, for the leaders in the ministry, for the community, for the world, for the gospel to go forward, for revival to break out, and we need everyone to come, and we need to get on the same page and lift up the name of Jesus. Amen? So let's have everybody come Monday night at 7 o'clock. Amen? Also, Sunday, tomorrow, every Sunday at 4 o'clock, we have our Spanish service with Pastor Dora. So if you're a Spanish-speaking person, we want to invite you to come and bring some people with you. We're really trying to kick off this service, and it's growing already, but I know there are a lot of other people out there that need to hear the Word of God. So please invite somebody and bring them tomorrow. This Friday night is our women's monthly meeting, Women Reaching Women. Amen. So I want to invite all the women to come out this Friday night at 6:30. Our theme this month is Show Me Your Glory. It's going to be awesome. And we're having pizza. So that's awesome, too. But I want you to bring somebody with you. Don't just come by yourself. We always have a great time. We have praise and worship and a powerful word. And we also have a lot of fun and fellowship. But I want you to bring people with you. It's not just for our body of believers, but the women's ministry is also an outreach to bring in those that are unsaved. So maybe invite your neighbor, a coworker, a family member, somebody that wouldn't normally come to church, and just tell them you're bringing them to a ladies' night out. And let's get them here. Let's get them saved. Let's get them healed and delivered. Amen. Also, the women's retreat is coming up October 14, 15, 16. There are sign-up sheets in the bookstore if you haven't signed up yet. We want all the ladies to have an opportunity to go. So please register for that. If you want to pay by credit or debit card, you can see me and I'll take your payment that way. If you want to pay by cash, they'll take your payment in the bookstore. I want to encourage you, if you're not able to go, if you would think about sponsoring someone else that wants to go, but maybe doesn't have the money. And that goes for all the men in here as well. If you would step up and do your part to help the women have that opportunity to go to the retreat, because God has a word for every woman that's going to be there, and I don't want any of you to miss out. Amen? We need at least 5 volunteers to help Pastor Ronnie move some office furniture this Tuesday morning at 9 a.m. So if you're available, you see Pastor Ronnie, wave your hand at us, okay? Praise God. Also, next weekend, I know there's a lot of stuff going on in the women's ministry. Praise God. Next weekend, Saturday and Sunday after the service, we're having a nachos fundraiser to help raise money for the retreat expenses. And we do need volunteers to help with that. If you would see Samantha right here in the front afterwards, and you can sign up to help with that. Praise God. I think that's it. We're going to take the offering right now. The ushers would prepare themselves to receive. I know. It's your opportunity to continue to worship God by giving to Him. Okay. Maybe we can get everybody on board. All right. Praise God. That's not everybody, he says. Yes. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He gave his best. Amen. And God wants us to do the same thing. So praise God. Are you guys ready to give tonight? All right. Just hold your offerings up. God, we just thank you for everything that you've given to us. God, we thank you that you've opened the windows of heaven and you've poured out a blessing on us, Father. And I just pray that we'd be faithful tonight, God, to give back to you a portion of what you've given to us, God. And that we would even give above and beyond that, Father. Whatever you put on our hearts tonight, God, help us to be faithful to this ministry and to the gospel going around the world. We thank you, God, for everything that you've already provided for this ministry, God. But we thank you that there's more that you want to do and that you're allowing us to each one be a part of what you're going to do in the future in this ministry. So we thank you right now. We give you all the honor, all the glory, and all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
Hey, everybody. My stage name is DBG, Driven by God, but my real name is Gabriel, so you can call me either one. And the song I have today is called You Can't Stop Me. It's called Can't Stop. My bad. And has anybody ever been going through anything hard that it feels like you can't make it through? But then God shows up and shows off and says that you're gonna make it through and that you can make it through no matter what happens. This is what this song is about. When I wrote this song, it was so hard because everything was coming against me and it was just hard. And it's hard to explain it. As I write these rhymes, Father, I need your strength and your peace and your love, cause all my rhymes come from you in everything I do. From the time that I wake up, from the time that I stay up all night wondering if I'm doing what's right, then the devil comes in like a thief in the night and tries to take my life, cause he knows God has a plan for me and I'm living it. Keep it for his glory and his honor, right? He's living it right. Sometimes I try and fight it, but I know I can't deny it. So I need to keep on pushing in this spiritual fight. If I don't, I did this all in vain, so what's the point? What am I doing here? What am I doing here? What am I doing here? I'm just gonna give up. No, I can't stop and I won't stop. So when I feel like giving up, I'm just gonna give it to the one who takes all of my sin. So Father, this I pray, take it all today, to take it all away. Take away my lust and my pride and my sinning, cause I wanna fit in with your word. So take this life of which I don't deserve, cause I'd rather have you than the whole universe. Yes, I'd rather have you than the whole universe. I'd rather have you than the whole universe. So Father, bring your fire down, bring your fire down, bring your fire down upon me and this place, so we can be with you eternally. Bring your fire down, 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 bring your fire down. Church, praise God. Because even though we're going through this rough time, He brings us through it, He brings us out, and He makes everything work out for His glory.
Come on, somebody. Ah, hallelujah. Let the Redeemer of the Lord say so in this place. Shout yeah! Amen. Awesome. Praise the Lord. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord at this time. We have with us from Home of Hope, Teen Challenge, with us here tonight again. I don't know who's coming up at this time. I'm not sure how we have this. At this time, give them a hand, amen, as they come and share, testify, minister. Praise the Lord, amen.
Thank you, Pastor Gus. Well, we are so excited to be here. We brought absolutely as many girls as we could cram into the van and cram into my car. So this is probably our favorite church to come and visit. So my name is Teresa Logue. I am the director of the Home of Hope. How many of you are familiar with Teen Challenge of Arizona? How about the Home of Hope? Okay, so we are a center located in Casa Grande for women and women with children. How many of you know that these little mamas very often won't get help because they're not going to leave their kids behind? So they live at our center for 12 to 15 months. And how many of you know that addiction isn't birthed out of, I think I'm going to mess my life up, right? I think I'm going to make my family want nothing to do with me. I think I'm going to lose my children to the state. Addiction is birthed in those broken places of our hearts, right? And so we don't address addiction at the Home of Hope. We introduce Jesus. I know, God is so good. And we invite Jesus to heal those broken places. And the Home of Hope is just a place where women come, meet Jesus, and are transformed. Amen? Amen. So I'd like to invite our ladies. They're going to do a song. So so we call them signs and wonders because we expect God to do signs and wonders as they usher in the very presence of God.
Don't know what to say, God.
I'm like a proud mama. They call me Mama T at the Home of Hope. Thank you, ladies. Shailene, you want to stay with me? So, you know, when a young lady comes into our program, she's pretty much tapped out everybody in her life financially. And I really, I just have a heart to rescue women. You know, we have intake fees and things we require when women come in. But the truth is, God doesn't require money from you when you need help. He's merciful, and he's just there for you. And so that's my heart, and that's my passion. Let me let you share, and then I'll share what I was going to share. This is Shailene. How long have you been in the program?
About over a month and a half.
She came to us from New Mexico, so I'm just going to let her share her story.
Hi, everybody. I'm Shailene. I'm from Albuquerque, New Mexico. I'm 30 years old. I have three children, two of them which are with me at the Home of Hope. Well, I was raised in a broken home, and I've done heroin and meth for 17 years, and I tried everything. I tried everything, and I faced planet finally. I found myself homeless on the street, strung out on heroin with both kids, alone. Everybody was done with me. My mom was done, everybody. So I faceplanted. I cried out to God. I didn't, God, help me. And he opened door after door after door. And I landed. I landed on Teresa's doorstep at the Home of Hope with the grace of God because I had no money. I didn't even have money for the bus ticket. Two churches raised money for me and my kids. We rode Greyhound fighting. Fighting to survive. Real talk. I was at my end. And all, through Christ, I could do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Just everything, every day. Since I've been at the Home of Hope, me and my kids, I'm a mother. I'm not just surviving every day. I don't wake up sick. I wake up and I give God praise. I see that sun. And it's beautiful. And I don't have to survive. I can live. I can breathe. I'm alive. And it's all, the glory all goes to God. Because without him, I would not be here today talking to you guys. And one of you guys are going to hear me and know you can be alive. You can live. True story.
So she was telling me before she came up here that she had some battle scars from the drugs that she used. And she has a lot of battle scars. But what did you say they were going to be?
They're going to be my battle scars. They're going to be a door opener. And somebody's going to listen to me one day because of them. That shame is going to go away. I was really ashamed of my scars. I cover them up. I have a crocodile that ate my legs. If you guys know what that is, it's bad. My arms, I felt ashamed, but God's taking that away. God's going to use my triumphs for his glory.
Amen. Because your testimony is prophecy to someone else. It's their victory. Amen? Amen. You know, at the Home of Hope, we're like family. Because when you love someone despite who you are, I need that. How about you? It brings healing. So we have a sponsorship program at the Home of Hope, and I like to encourage. I was a businesswoman that worked all the time. I started out as a Home of Hope girl. God just blessed me. And then he brought me all the way back around. But because I have my own story. But I just believe God does things two ways. I believe that he knits hearts together. And so we developed a sponsorship program at the Home of Hope so that anyone who wanted to be involved with a student and their progress in the program would see it by getting monthly newsletters. We also give you permission to send a card, an encouraging word, a prophetic word. Yeah. And we do not conceal your identity or expose who you are until graduation. For those people that sponsor students, we send you a special invitation during graduation. And we invite you to see the transformation. You get those monthly pictures, you get those monthly updates, but there's nothing like seeing from start to finish the transformation and to see what you've invested in. And that information is on the back table. So always need at the Home of Hope. I went to a training all day today and the lady sent me home with a case of toilet paper. Do we not rejoice with cases of toilet paper? Come on up, Rebecca. We're girls. We like stuff like that. It's needed. So this is Rebecca.
Hello. Hello. My name is Rebecca Fontenot. I got to the Home of Hope August 8th. I want to finish my 30 days. So praise God for that. So I practiced my testimony. And if you guys can think of your very first memory of life, first memory you ever have. Mine started at the age of 6. It was the day my family came home because my cousin was abducted. And I was 6 years old, she was 8, and then 6 months later, my parents split up. And then around the same time, there was a gentleman in our neighborhood that was taking on women and abusing them and whatnot. So all of my sisters, I have 4 sisters, we were sheltered. We were kept inside the house, we weren't allowed to go out. And then with my dad not around and my mom's 6 brothers, very protective. You're right, you do get a little nervous up here. You do get a little nervous up here. Let me just say, I thought I had this. Anyway, so we stayed inside. I took care of my sisters. And then junior high had a great life because my grandpa was a preacher. And grandma really instilled a lot in us, especially Isaiah 54:17, no weapons will be forged against you. Absolutely. And so high school, really good. Listen to my parents, but the day I turned 18, I saw anything and everything I can have. And I found it in a guy who was a well-known biker in town, and he had some power, and a lot of people feared him, and I got used to that power and fear. Got away with pretty much anything and everything I wanted. And had a nephew, started raising him, and then marriage really didn't last well, and I was using a lot. I was using meth, cocaine, hallucinogens, and one day things just got bad, let's just say, and I walked away. And I know it was God. It had to be him, because for 10 years of abuse, I went to my uncle's house, who's a God-fearing man, and I never touched it again. And August 13th of this year was my 13 years sober from using any of that. 13 long years, but it was grateful years. Absolutely. So I met my second husband, and things were great for a couple years, and his niece got into a lot of trouble, and she was entered into Springboard, who is for the young girls in Tucson. And she did great with the program, and then about a year later, unfortunately, my husband fell back to cocaine. So I put him into the men's center, and he did really good. He did like 17 months, actually. He interned for a while. And then, so that's how I found out about Teen Challenge, so I got a little bit of everywhere in Arizona, Teen Challenge, a family. And then, unfortunately, our marriage didn't survive, but I put myself into work, and I became an office manager and an executive assistant to a CEO, and just poured everything into it, and kind of started ignoring my daughter. Oh, by the way, I have a daughter. She's 14. Just really got into work, became a really bad workaholic, and became a very bad alcoholic. February this year, I finally confessed on how much I was drinking to someone, and I was hospitalized for a month. Completely system shut down, and then March, April, and the 1st of May, I graduated from a program, and a week later, I picked back up. And I found myself in the hospital a couple times up until July 23rd, and my family walked into the hospital room because I didn't even know where I was and said, "You're going to Teen Challenge." And here I am. And I'm sober
50 days today, 50 days. Thank you.
So what has it been like at the Home of Hope, which is a scary thing to ask someone who's only been there 30 days?
No, it's great. It's, you know, you get to see other people's stories, testimonies, personalities, and whatnot. Unfortunately, I don't have my daughter at the house, and the first couple days was really hard because I swear every child in the house looked like her, even though, you know, they were smaller and she's 14. But it's been good. You start off in the kitchen, so that's been something different. I spent a lot of years cooking for kids and then, you know, went through the fast food angle, so...
Because in the kitchen, that's where the music is. That's where the dancing is. These ladies stand around the trash can and pray.
And sign.
But I got a picture on my Facebook. You got to go to my Facebook. Where they are throwing away the garbage before they start the day. They are forgiving. They are repenting. And they are moving on. Thank you, sweetheart. So both of those ladies were kind of new sharing, and this is a safe place to do it, right? Right? So I just want to say that I feel so loved. We all feel so loved when, Pastor Gus, you come and minister to us, or when we come here and be with you. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you. If you feel led to support the Home of Hope or help these ladies in their program, you can go to our website at tcaz.org. You can get information on the back table. You can find us on Facebook, Home of Hope. Isn't that our... Yep, Kylie's over there. Kylie manages all that. She's a graduate. She's fabulous. Thank you, Pastor Gus, for having us.
Praise the Lord. Come on now, give him a hand. So watching at home right now, because this is live and it's going to be recorded later on. Some people are going to hear the testimonies and they're going to be moved by the Lord. I know God's going to move on some hearts. Repeat the information because someone might be in another state right now or in another country. And God is speaking to them right now to do something. Do it. Okay, so and if so, as they're getting ready to do it, because they're getting ready to do it in Jesus' name, direct them again where they can.
Yes, sir. So you can go to TC Teen Challenge, Arizona, AZ, tcaz.org. You can actually call the Home of Hope at 520-836-0573. And we can always use your help. There's always another lady out there who needs help. Let's bring them in and get them the help that they need.
So this is what we're going to do, too, okay? Check this out. So, and remember, there are tables in the back. And then also, Grand Junction, Colorado. Amen. You know who I'm talking to. They're watching right now at my sister's house. I already talked to my sister over here. So it's thumbs up for your daughter. So,
yes.
Okay, so let you, just tell her.
We got you covered. We'll give you a call on Monday, and we'll work everything out.
All right. So you'll be getting a phone call from them on Monday. Praise God. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's not the way we start. It's the way we finish. Amen. So what we're going to do also is, and you have to, what I want to do before they leave, I want our church, and you know what? And on the way out, make sure, you know, if God moves again, so, you know, just write out a check, whatever, you know, direct at their table back there or monthly or whatever. I'm, you know, like right now, I was in conversation on behalf of somebody else, and it was automatic. She's like, okay, we got this, you know, just this is what needs to be done. And I was saying earlier, I don't think people really do real. I mean, we just don't know the whole story. And I would not want somebody assuming, like, because you know what? God knows the heart. Man looks at the outward appearance. God knows the heart. And people don't know the whole story. But all I know is it's not the way you start. It's the way you finish. Shout, I'm a finisher! Yeah, yeah, yeah. And God will take our brokenness, put it together so we can reach the broken. Amen? So I want to write a check before they leave for $3,000 on behalf of our church, okay? And I'm doing that on and I said that not because, like, oh, look at what we're doing. Yeah, so, and if anybody, I'm doing that so people watching at home, so I'm not saying, oh, look, we just did 3,000, because that's just so small compared to what the need is, okay? Okay, for one person, one of the women, $2,000 a month for them to be going through. Do you hear that? So we just barely, it's just a little above, so we've just taken care of somebody for a month and a half as a church. Do you understand what I'm saying? But that's still, that's, if we're going to be the church, let's be the church. Amen. Amen. For real. Or else, let's not, I'm out. You know what I mean? Let's do, if we're going to do it, let's do something real. Let's do something that's changing lives. And let's not play church. Let's be the church. Amen. Shout amen. So make sure before they leave, you write out a check for $3,000. And I'm saying that to store up everybody, because I believe God's speaking to some people for the future and watching at home. And maybe there's some people, maybe there's some pastors, maybe there's some ministers right now that are listening. Amen. Just obey the Lord and watch how God blesses you and the church and the vision and the assignment. Because what you help make happen for others, God will make happen for you. And we're all on the same team. And we need one another. And together we finish and we do this in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Shout hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. And at this time, how do you want me to, like, present you? Like
that guy.
It's that guy from Florida. Give Mark a hand.
That guy. I didn't mean it for you to say it that way. It's okay. It's all right. I can take it.
I got it. Evangelist. Bishop.
Oh, no.
No, evangelist. Mighty man of God.
Come on now.
Come on, let him know how much we think. How many are you thankful for Mark being with us once again? Let him know we love him. Come on.
Jesus. I am a child of God. Come on, let's bring that back up.
I'm no longer slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Hallelujah. Jesus.
With the melody, hallelujah, you surround.
Yes!
for all those that you've rescued and all that you're going to rescue tonight. All those people that can't say I'm a child of God, but tonight they're going to leave here saying, I am a child of God. I am a child of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Do you believe? Hallelujah. Because he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen. Give him praise and glory. Give him praise and glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you praise, Jesus. We come here tonight to worship you in spirit and in truth. And how we do that is we be true to ourselves. That's how we do it in truth. We have to come to the realization of who we are, what we've been doing, where we've gone wrong, and short, and admit it to ourselves, and then we admit it to God. And we say, sorry, I'm sorry, Lord. Forgive me for all my trespasses. Forgive me for all my shortcomings. Forgive me for all my falling short or stepping back and stepping away from you. I'm sorry, Lord. And the Lord says, I love you and I forgive you. Just come back to me and move forward. Amen. Praise Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your anointing, for your presence and your power here. Fill us, Lord, today. Let everyone walk out of this place changed forever, revived, renewed, rebirthed in Jesus' name. Lord, we give you praise and glory and honor. Lord, let your Holy Spirit move. Let your Holy Spirit move. And we lay it all at the cross for what you've done for us. What you've done for us. Pray to him. Worship him right now. Lift your voice. Just worship him in any way that you know how. Show him how much you love him right now. Oh, we love you, Lord. God, I can't tell you how much. Words don't explain how I feel about you, Lord. I can't express it, Father. But my heart yearns out to you, and my heart pours out all my love for what you've done for me. There's a place for mercy. There's a place. There's a place, praise you, God. That place is right here, right now, for all of us. For all the love I've ever found, it flows like a flood. Right now, it's flowing down at the cross.
At the cross.
I'm in awe of you, Lord. And we give you all the praise and all the glory. Father, use us tonight. Begin to use us by your Spirit. Begin to fill us with the power and glory.
Watch us as we continue to worship the Lord. I want us to, a few seconds here, gather around these altars, and we got the prison ministry that are going out to the different prisons and different places, about 500 inmates, to encourage them, to let them know it's not the way you start, it's the way you finish. And to bring healing, restoration. If someone doesn't know the Lord, that they come into a relationship with them. CDs have a way of making their way around the units too, amen. And if you're watching at home and you know somebody, a family member or friend, somebody that can benefit, let us know, email us, get a hold of us. Just send us the information, and we got the rest covered. And God's blessed this church to be able to do this. You know, there's no charge or anything like that. Just let's do this. Amen. So, and remember, Moses took a life and became the senior pastor of the biggest church in the world. You know what I'm saying? Don't you give up on anybody. Amen. So, like right now, as we worship the Lord, I just feel right now, you know what? As we pray for God's healing power right now, restoration, healing, and just whatever the situation might be, as these go out this week. When are we sending these out? Monday? So, and that's throughout the state of Arizona and throughout different places in the country, different other places too. And there's a lot of people that have come through this church and have come and testified. Actually, I was just talking to Pastor Benny from Soldiers Across. That was a prison minister. I remember we were going back years ago. Soldiers Across discipleship, you know. And it's awesome. As we pray for these, I just believe, as we take our focus off ourselves and focus on these soldiers that God's raising up here, that God's going to do something and start healing and delivering in this place. So who has a need in this place? All right, look at your neighbor and say, take the focus off your need right now. Okay, okay. What you sow is what you reap, right? So when we sow Jesus, our prayer, our encouragement, as we lay hands here, we're sowing Jesus, we're sowing life, we're sowing salvation, victory, breakthrough, turnaround, restoration. I have an explosion that's going to hit this place and sweep across this place here tonight. Amen. In your life. Yes. Chains are going to break. Yes. People are going to be healed, delivered, set free, and watching at home as you come in agreement with us. Amen. So as we worship the Lord, we start to continue to worship the Lord. I just want us to step out of our seats right now a little bit and get as close as you can, and let's lay hands on these right here. Amen. Come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah, fire. Stay right with you. Keep on.
not going back. Moving forward, we're prop. This is to everybody in here, but to every package, every person, that they're not going back. That this is after they get. There's no going. They're moving forward.
Yes.
The cycle yes. breaks right now. Cycle yes. breaks right now. The cycle breaks right now. The cycle
right
breaks
now.
Right now. Never going back, but yes. moving forward, yes. rising up. Anointed, dangerous, mighty voices for God.
We're here to declare to you, Lord, our past is over.
Music.
In you, so made new our lives to Christ. Your past is over in you, Lord.
bondage is broken in the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. Right now. Right now. Right now. Right now. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. That addiction is broken in the name of Jesus.
No, 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 no.
Claim it. Claim it. That broken marriage is restored in the name of Jesus. That broken marriage is restored in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. That appetite goes. Yeah, come on.
Cancer is healed right now in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
All cells renewed in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
All pain, physical pain, I declare it to be gone now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Right now. Right now. Right now.
Every appetite. Unhealthy addictions right now. Go now, now, now. The appetite goes now, 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 now. Now! Now! For your glory, 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 right now, 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 now. Come on, come on, come on, don't stop. Don't look around, look at. He's your healer, he's your deliverer. Come on, come on. Yeah. Now, 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 put your hand right in your stomach. Yeah, yeah. Now, now, there it is, right there, right there. Come on, come on. Now, watching at home, come on. If you believe, you shall see my glory. Call upon his name right now. Now, 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 now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, 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 for your glory, 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 for your glory. It's an altar tonight, never to be forgotten. Tonight, 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 for your glory, your glory. Come on, worship, worship, worship. You don't even, come on. Keep worshiping, keep worshiping. Now, 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 for your glory, glory, for your glory, to you be all the glory and all the honor, all the glory, all the glory. All the glory, all the glory, all the glory to you, Lord. We know apart from you, we can do nothing. Thank you for your amazing grace, your mercy, your patience, your love with us, Lord God, for this night, for this opportunity, for this moment, for this second. We bless your name in this place. 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 We bless your holy name in this place. Yeah. Every hindrance, spirit of fear breaks in the name of Jesus. For you haven't given us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. Heaviness and depression
goals now in the name of Jesus. Now, 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 now. I bind and break the spirit of suicide right now in the name of Jesus. And I loose power, sound mind. And Lord, right now in the name of Jesus, let your people in this place and watching at home bring courage right now. Holy Ghost. Spirit. Speak to your people. Show them how much, how great, how much you love them and how great of a plan and purpose you have for their lives. In the name of Jesus, right now, right now, right now, right now, right now. Dreams, assignments, purposes, revive, 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 revive. Where the enemy has come to steal, kill, and Lord, the greatness, the purpose, the assignment, because of the impact. Of the impact of these precious hearts, Lord God, that you, how you want to use and use to impact, to bring hope and life and breakthrough and restoration. Lord, tonight, revive, resurrect greatness, power, the assignment for your glory. For your glory, 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 for your glory. And Lord, a fire, Lord God, to flow through every single person. Lord, heal the broken pieces, bring them together. And Lord, as your people go forth, Lord God, thank you for your provision, your favor, your grace, power. And Lord, that they'll go forth with a fire and a power to reach the broken, Lord God, in the highways, the byways, for your glory, in the name of Jesus. Fire, fire. My God, shatta yara la ha, shatta yara. Fire. For your glory, 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 for your glory. And Lord, a boldness, Lord God, a boldness, Lord God, to go. Hallelujah. Fire, 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 fire. Lord, thank you. For this, for these soldiers. Lord, I thank you for ones watching and in this place, and they're going to change the world for your glory, raising up for such a time as this, for such a time as this, for such a time as this, raising up for such a time as this, for your glory. Just lift up your hands. Fire. Just worship. It's not by might, nor by power, but it's by the Lord. Put your hand, pray for it right in her stomach. Pray for your wife right now. Yeah, right there. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Freedom. For your glory, for your glory, for your glory, for your glory, for your glory. for your glory, 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 for your glory. Increase for your glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Just worship, worship. Lift up your hands, lift up your hands. Yeah, come on, worship, worship.
Thank you. Get ready. Get ready.
Not one person leave this place. Not one person leave this place. God has something for every one of us. Every one of us.
Praise you, Lord.
Got out of your seat. Take that step of faith and stand up right now. Take that step of faith right now.
I exalt. Just worship him and he'll answer you. He'll answer you.
Be free.
Be free.
Healing. We find healing in the name of Jesus.
Is there anybody in this place that has never openly experienced their want and their need to ask the Lord Jesus to come into your heart? And you at home, as you're watching, right now is an opportunity. It may be your last chance. It may be your last chance. God's saying, come to me. I still love you. I still love you. If there's anybody in this house that hasn't given their heart to the Lord, I encourage you right now, take that step of faith. For the Lord said that all those who believe in me and confess it with your mouth, that he is the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, and he raised from the dead, that those who believe shall be saved. Shall be saved. Amen. And if that's you, come down here right now. Come down here to this altar right now, and we're going to pray with you. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. He was slain for you and you and you. He's holy. He's holy. He's holy. Right now, if that's you, come down here right now. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Can you all stand with me for a second? God has touched us. God has moved. God has done wonderful things tonight. Amen. He's encouraged. He's broken chains. He's refreshed. He's renewed. He's healed. He's delivered. Jesus, his glory. Amen. Praise God. We're going to pray right now. And I know that I know, because there was one day I was one of them, that I couldn't walk up to the front in a church. But the Holy Spirit was still stirring in me, and I had to sit and stand in my seat. And I'm encouraging you right now. So we're all going to pray together, and you at home, we're going to pray with you right now. And I want you to say this prayer. Say, Lord Jesus, I believe you're the Son of God. And you died on the cross for me. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. Forgive my sins. Cleanse my soul. And use me. I am yours forever. I'm never going back. I'm moving forward today in your mighty name. I thank you, God, and I'm all yours in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, we praise you, God. Give him praise and glory. it so tonight. Tonight is your new beginning. No matter what you've been through, you walk out of this place renewed, refreshed, and you claim it. The devil wants to defeat you, but you tell him that he's a liar. And you tell him, I am a child of the King. I am a child of God. Amen. Amen. Give him praise and glory. Hallelujah. Glory, glory.
Come on, lift up your hands, lift up your hands. Lord, we give you all the glory, we give you all the honor. Lord, we just thank you right now. We thank you for what you've done, for what you're doing in our midst, and for what you're about to do. Thank you. For the soldiers that you're raising up, the champions, in this house and watching at home for your glory. And I decree and declare that the latter will be great and the former the finished, greater than the start, in Jesus' name, for the saving of many lives, for his glory. Praise the Lord. Yeah, let's sing that song. Let's just finish with that song. Yeah. We'll be back here tomorrow morning. Service at 10:30 between 9 and 10. Breakfast, come join us. Amen. And praise the Lord. And you guys make yourselves available. And also, Mark Martin's CDs and music store also. So you guys make yourselves available to that also. It'll bless you or be a blessing to somebody else. Amen. All right.
the joy in here.